Hey everybody, I'm Jamie Provience, and today I want to share with you some ideas on how to choose a steak and get it ready for grilling. Because sometimes the decisions that you make in the store and what you do to prep the steak make as much of a difference as your techniques on the grill. So let's look at a couple of steaks that I picked up at the store. One of them I really like and the other I don't like so much, and I'll tell you why. This one over here is a good looking steak. And the reason it is primarily the marbling, the thickness, the bone, and the integrity. The marbling is the fat, basically. The little streaks of milky white fat running through the steak are really important for the juiciness of the steak and for the flavor. Here the marbling is nice and evenly distributed. Over here, I don't see as much distribution of fat, and the fat that is around is clumped up. There are large sections of fat. And the problem with that is that those tend to melt pretty quickly and potentially cause flare-ups. They also cause some gaps in the steak. See how this one, for instance, this bit of fat here is right between two muscles, basically, and when that melts away, there's going to be a hole, and the steak is basically going to fall apart. You're going to have a scraggly piece of meat. Over here, the clumps are not so big. The meat is held a little bit better together. It has better integrity. I think that makes for a better steak overall. Now, another big issue is the thickness of the steak. Both of them are roughly an inch, maybe an inch and a quarter thick, and that's a pretty good thickness to start with. You want to go higher than that rather than lower than that. A thin steak tends to overcook really quickly in the center. It's hard to sear both sides of the steak and still leave the interior, you know, nice and juicy and rosy red. So I find that about an inch is the minimum you can go. And of course, the thickness should be even throughout. You can see that this one was cut so that one end of the steak is actually much thinner than the other end, and that's going to create some unevenness of doneness. So you want to have a nice even thickness throughout. So once you've got a well-marbled, evenly cut, perfectly big bone-in ribeye steak, how do you get it ready for the grill? Well, I think one of the most important things to do is to salt the steak 20 to 30 minutes before you grill it. A couple of really important things happen during that time. Number one, the steak loses its very cold temperature, right? It comes out of the refrigerator very cold, and if you were to put it right on the grill immediately, it would actually take longer to cook. And the longer that it cooks on the grill, the greater the chance that it's going to dry out. Okay? As you cook any piece of meat, juices are pushed out of the meat. And so with a steak, the idea is to cook it pretty much as quickly as possible without actually burning it, of course. Another really important thing happens during this time is that the salt begins to work on the steak. You've probably heard that salt draws moisture out of a steak, right? And you don't want to do that for hours and hours and hours because you'll dry out the steak. And that's true, but if you do it for just 20 or 30 minutes, actually that little bit of moisture that comes to the surface of the steak makes for a beautiful, really delicious crust on the surface. So if you just take a little bit of care to pick a great looking steak and season it well ahead of time, you've set yourself up for a great dining experience. Now, it's just a matter of firing up the grill and letting the meat hit the heat.